All right. We are back here at Song of the Day, coming to you from the Rock Cave. I'm your host, Mark Pierce. What we got going on today? Today's a big day, and I didn't give it as much fanfare from the last few years. But season 3 concluded, and this is episode 1 of season 4, renewed yet again for another season. Awesome. Season 3, we clocked in at almost 200 episodes after doing 365 a year for those first couple of years. 200 episodes in a season, still pretty awesome, right? We'll see. That's probably about the same we'll do for season 4, I think. But season 3, another great year here in the cave. Looking forward to more stuff in season 4. I've got all these ideas about stuff I want to do, but just life. I mean, I do work. Life gets in the way. Creativity sometimes. But first and foremost, this week, or this past Monday, Connecticut UConn Huskies. Where's my hat? Oh, I forgot to bring my hat. Proud Husky alum here in my house, my wife, my sister-in-law, so many friends. Well, the men's basketball championship. Go Huskies. Back on the map. We could have done that as a theme. I should have done that if I hadn't gotten so little sleep. We would have done, for the championship, we could have done the theme of the dog. Songs about dogs, like Dogs from Pink Floyd. I Want to Be Your Dog. That was Iggy Pop or The Stooges. A remake by Joan Jett was pretty good. Dogs of War, another Pink Floyd song. Hair of the Dog, Nazareth. Love that song. Love the cowbell on that one. He's My Dog from Brett Denon. Or maybe a band. You could have Three Dog Night. We could keep going on, but we won't. But wait, this is season 4 of the Rock Cave. So we could, for fourth season, we could do Foreigner 4. We could do Led Zeppelin 4. We could play Four Sticks. Four Non-Blondes. Four in the Morning from Night Ranger. I forgot about that song. Got any fours in there? What else? It was four. Post below, all you creative people. I gotta kick season 4 off with something heavy, and that's what we're gonna do, some hard rock and stuff, because there was an anniversary this past week here in music land, and that is we're going back 20 years ago. The White Stripes release, guess what? Their fourth album, that's right, Elephant. Oh, man, this is so good. Oh, yeah, this is great stuff right here. This is heavy. What's going on here with this record? Different covers, all kinds of different covers. Slight movement changes on pictures between the UK edition, the United States edition, tapes or cassettes or CDs or records. A little bit, some differences there. But this is their fourth album. Remember, they're coming off of highly successful White Blood Cells from 2001. Again, this is 2003, but 2001, White Blood Cells, that started to put them on the map. Dead Leaves and the Dirty Ground started getting a lot of attention on alternative radio. And we're Gonna Be Friends was in Napoleon Dynamite, right? Was that the beginning? Think about this. 2003... Rock and roll, we were just starving for something good. We were just trying to figure out, like, what is the post-grunge rock world look like? Where is great rock and roll? We were kind of mired in, we couldn't figure it out. We were stuck with Three Doors Down, Papa Roach, Our Lady of Peace, Godsmack, Nickelback, Hoobastank, Puddle of Mud, Creed. Not to say anything wrong about those bands, but we were, where was rock and roll exactly? These guys were just on an upward trajectory, and this record just knocked it out of the park. We'll get back to that idea in just a minute. Let's run these numbers. Recorded in 2 weeks, they used old school equipment, no computers, no instrument that was not dated later than 1963, recorded in the UK. Four singles, went to number six in the United States, 4 million copies around the world, 2 million in the US. Album of the Year, nomination for, at the Grammys, won Best Alternative Album, and Best Song for Seven Nation Army. This is what they call Garage Rock Revival, I guess is what they technically called it, but boy, this was a kick in the teeth right when we needed it. You think about the Strokes in 2001, they were giving us some hope for like good old Garage Rock Revival with that album, This Is It. Jet wouldn't be out till the following year after this record, 2004. And Green Day's American Idiot didn't come out till 2004. So really, this is exactly what we needed. And when this record just kicks some serious butt, you can skip over all the stuff that was surrounding them at this time. I mean, there were ex-spouses pretending to be siblings, the whole candy cane colors and everything, and black and white and red. But the fact of the matter is they could just play some kick-ass rock and roll, and this record is awesome. David Frick from Rolling Stone magazine said, a work of pulverizing perfection. And I was so excited for this record when I heard it. I was did not disappoint. Amazing record, released on Third Man Records. I've been to Third Man Records in Nashville. You got to go to that, see that. I wore that shirt earlier this week. But so good. And what are the songs on here? You got Seven Nation Army. That song is just currently still played. That first guitar lick is played in stadiums, sports stadiums all around America. And everyone knows it, knows those riffs, even if they don't know the band or the song. Still to this day, and Jack White loves it. He says, that's fine. I'm good with that. I just don't know what to do with myself. That's a Burt Bacharach song that Dusty Springfield sang, I think. That was pretty interesting. In the Cold, Cold Night, awesome. Love that one. That's the first time Meg sang lead on a song. She was always doing backup vocals. The Hardest Button to Button. Right there. There it is. Love that jam right there. Little Acorns. That's a quirky little thing. Those little acorns, love that. That's something cool in there. Well, It's Time We Love One Another. Obviously, another funky, cool song. And then you got Ballin' Biscuit. Ballin' Biscuit is the insane song. That is my favorite song on the whole record. That's just melt your face off. Again, kick you in the sternum, punch you in the teeth. Rock and roll. So good. If you don't know Ballin' Biscuit, you got to check this record out if you don't know this one. This is amazing. Ballin' Biscuit. The Hardest Button to Button. Little Acorns. Yeah, so good. And this is a great way to start season four. Again, the White Stripes. We're gonna continue this conversation about them with Wanderlust Wednesday. I think next Wednesday. If you know what I'm talking about, you know. But that's your song of the day right there, Ball and Biscuit from the White Stripes. Exactly what we needed in 2003, 20 years ago. And 4 years ago, we kicked off Song of the Day here in the Rock Cave. Thanks for sticking with me all these years. New fans out there, welcome to another year. Remember, you can catch all 970 episodes on YouTube. Spend a few weeks just checking me out, but that's good stuff. Hopefully more people here in the cave, either physically or remote recordings. I got some stuff lined up, but we're going to do some good stuff again here in season four. So whatever you're doing today, hope it involves music. And as usual, happy fourth. We'll catch you on the flip side.